This is New Day Northwest. Now, here's Margaret Larson.
Welcome, everybody. More than five decades ago, Mike Love helped create a sound that would forever evoke the beach and endless summer. The Beach Boys notched countless hits, and even though their lineup has changed over the years, the band's classic sound lives on in videos and live concerts. Mike Love shares his incredible experience in his memoir, Good Vibrations, My Life as a Beach Boy, just released in paperback, which is, by the way, perfect for the beach. He is here for two events, and we're thrilled to have him here this morning. Please welcome the one and only Mike Love. It is great to have you in town. So you've got some stuff going on, and we'll tell everybody about that at the end of the segment. But I was interested in your book to read a little bit about your parents and grandparents and how they influenced your early life. Tell us more.
I grew up in a home with a grand piano, an organ, and a harp. My mom was incredibly into music. She sang, it was just a big deal, on the radio in the 1930s.
That is a big deal.
She sang light opera, and she just loved music, and we had recitals and everything. Every Christmas, we would have a Christmas party where we'd all do Christmas carols, and we'd get a truck from Love Sheet Metal, my father's and my grandfather's company, and the adults would get on the truck, and the kids would run around behind it, and we'd do Christmas caroling throughout the neighborhood. So that has been a part of my life, that whole musical the musical environment has always been part of my reality.
I imagine she sang before you were even born and you heard it. So the music
and her
was
mother
truly
played the piano. It's
awesome.
That's
but
how
you
we grew
up in Southern California.
Yes.
Even though your parents and grandparents are from elsewhere. And you write about sort of the beach scene, the beginning of surf days. Yeah. And I'm fascinated by this because I've only seen this kind of in the movies, or I remember Gidget when I was a really little kid, you know, talking about surfing and going, oh my gosh, that looks so great. What was that time like?
It was fascinating because Southern California in the 40s, 50s, and 60s was just such a pristine place. And it still exists, and little pockets of serfdom still exist. But it was just a fascinating thing. We would be in high school and we'd listen to the surf report, and if they were talking about the surf was up, then we might miss an afternoon class, sadly. But it
possibly
was fun.
Could leave school for
a
while.
It was a lot of fun, though.
How did that culture, what grew up around the surf culture, influence the music, and the music influence the surf culture?
Well, our music was influenced by, you know, all the church music, doo-wop music, the Everly Brothers, the Four Freshmen were an incredible influence on us, and just the fact that we grew up in a musical environment. But the environment in which we lived, California, very close to the beach, that gave us the original subject matter for our songs.
Right.
And it was fun. And it's kind of strange because we did Surf and Safari, and it
and
was
everybody
a hit
knows every word to that song.
It was a hit in like Sweden. so go figure. But it turns out that surfing is close to serpent, which means drinking.
Oh,
so
well,
anyway,
see,
I don't know.
You're international. You can translate that any way you want. How did you guys get together, and how did the sound find you, or you find the sound?
We loved harmonies, and I like singing the bass parts. I'm known for singing the leads on many of the songs that were hit songs. That's because I sat with my cousin Brian, and we wrote the song together, and I was singing out the lyrics as we developed the song. He was playing the piano. He came up with the great chord progressions that we're known for, and he focused on the harmonies. I focused on the lyrics and the what they call the hooks. You know, the things like round, round, get around, I get around, or...
Was
you
that
know,
yours?
Fun, till her daddy takes the tea bitter away.
Oh my
or something
gosh,
like
that's
that.
My fave.
Yeah.
that's great. My fave. What is your favorite memory from the beginning of the band as you guys became known and when you kind of realized, oh my gosh, we're onto something?
One of my favorite memories was when we were promoted as the Beach Boys. The first time we were promoted on the radio as the Beach Boys as part of a Ritchie Valens Memorial Dance and Show in Long Beach Memorial Auditorium. And Ike Turner and his Kings of Rhythm, featuring the Ikettes, were on the show. And it blew my mind how incredible Tina Turner was.
Yeah.
Just blew my mind. I'll never forget how.
How old were you when you saw her then?
20.
Oh my gosh, that would just freeze your wires forever, right? She's so awesome.
It pretty much did. So anyway, but there are things like that that stood out. And we got $300 and we each got $60, there were five of us. So we thought, hey, that's pretty good.
That's
three songs and $60, not bad.
If it never gets any better, we'll love it. We'll love it.
Well, we went back about a decade later, and it was quite a significant improvement economically.
Yeah, I'm glad. You know, the Beach Boys are one of those bands that we've kind of passed down from generation to generation. I don't know how many now, but young people love the music. People my age love the music, and everybody in between. Do you have any thoughts about what keeps it so fresh?
Well, I think it's at the core, it's the harmonies and the love of singing the harmonies. When we got together, it wasn't about being famous. It wasn't about making any money at it. We just got together and created those harmonies together. And the true love of singing and the feeling that one gets from hearing those types of harmonies, it transcends all kinds of things. It's just, I don't know. I think at the core, that's the secret sauce about the Beach Boys.
It's awfully beautiful music, and it does just immediately make you feel better when you listen to it. I don't know what it is, but it's a lift every time. So there's also this very strange intersection between the Beach Boys and the Manson family at one point. Can you explain to us what happened? Because that is just the most chilling thing.
It was. And my cousin Dennis met a couple of girls hitchhiking on the road, and he invited them to his home. And then we went on a tour, and then when he came back, these were girls that were Charlie Manson's family members.
He had no idea when he picked them
up. Not really, but Charlie was in his home along with these 10 or 12 girls, and so my cousin didn't mind that at all. But we never knew that he was, you know, turned out how it turned out. In fact, I was called in the book, I mentioned, I only met the man once. We were invited to dinner at my cousin Dennis's home. And Bruce Johnson and I were the only persons with clothing on.
Interesting. So, that's an intense dinner.
It was weird, and he was very intense. But it is in my book.
Right. Yeah. And what ended up happening to get him out of your cousin's house and away from
my cousin
you guys?
Just abandoned the house.
He
was renting it, and he just didn't go back. Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah.
So as the decades have gone by, when you look back on all of this, is there a favorite song, a favorite musical moment, a favorite hook you have?
Well, I wrote the words to Good Vibrations on the way to the studio. The track was done over several different months. Different.
You mean like you scribbled it down?
No, I dictated to my then wife.
Mm-hmm.
And and so we got to the studio, and I gave the lyrics to my cousin Carl, who sang the beautiful verses. I came up with the, I'm picking up good vibrations. But I wrote the entire lyric of the song, and that was part of the collaboration between my cousin Brian and I. So that on the strength of that song, we were voted the number one group in Great Britain, number two being the Beatles, so that was kind of special.
That must have been incredible.
Nobody's been more popular than the Beatles, but that was pretty sweet.
Do you know where that inspiration comes from when it comes to you like that?
I've always been interested in poetry. I mean, I wrote a couple of poems about girls I had a crush on in junior high school, but I also read copiously, and I would read literature and of all kinds, English literature, American literature, and some of that was poetry, and I really had an affinity to that. I loved words and languages too. I was really pretty good in Spanish, but not very good at all in physics or chemistry or math.
You and I would have been the same student.
Oh
then.
My God, it was challenging. That hemisphere of my brain didn't show up.
What? The hemisphere that did great. Yeah, so don't worry about that. You're working now with some younger musicians, and I'm hoping you're passing on some of the love of the poetry and the music and the harmonies. Tell us a bit about that part of your life.
The interesting thing is that my daughter Amba is singing with me on some songs and stuff. Yeah, and my son Christian, my son Brian, and my other daughter Haley. So it's that family tradition mm-hmm. of music keeps going on and on.
That is amazing. Tell us about this music video. Who's in this?
Oh, that's John Stamos. That's Mike Love.
Who still looks like he's 25.
And Mark McGrath is in there too. Do it again. we did that video while we were in D.C. on July 4th this last summer.
Was that fun?
It was more fun than you could possibly imagine, because Mark McGrath is so, you know, he brings so much energy to the situation. So we did this song called Do It Again. That's the name of the song that's being played. And so, yeah, look at McGrath.
Tell you what,
is,
we'll take it up full sound here so people can
nice.
Hear it.
Some retro, yeah, that's me back in the day.
That is so great. Oh, look at this. That's an incredibly great idea.
Well, John Stamos came up with the concept, and he pretty much produced the whole video, which was great.
That is awesome. Listen, I just really want to thank you. You guys have given us so much great music and so much fun over the years, and a way to connect with other people. I don't know if you really know that, but it's an amazing human connection to enjoy that music together.
Now we're going
to
connect with a few humans tomorrow night.
Yes, you are. You are.
Yeah, we sure are.
Try to stay away from the animals, but connect with the humans.
Right.
Mike has two events in Western Washington. Tonight he's going to discuss and sign copies of Good Vibrations at University Bookstore in Seattle. And then tomorrow night you can catch the Beach Boys in concert at the Washington State Fair in Puyallup. More information is on the website for you, but do not miss it. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
To meet
Thanks
you.
A lot.
All right, coming up, we're going to talk about school meals for your kids' brain power. We'll be back after this.